Hello, today it's Chief. We're on Ark Survival, Aberration, and we are going to build a smaller greenhouse than what we have. Try to learn others the basics of building one. So let's grab Bulldog, gather up our resources. And head on out. This is my room that my daughter also tried to make. Freya made me. The green stuff is hanging down from the cliff above. It shouldn't be in here, but it is. But it also adds decor to the room. And we can thank Eco's for most of the decoration here, if not all of it. Yes, in case you're wondering, the bathtub, you can lay in it. Cool. First thing I need to do is make sure I got food, water, got it. Now, greenhouse, I guess we'll use the castle keeps foundations. Cooking. Let's figure out what greenhouse this is. Freya has got her greenhouse. With the Eco's now. Oh, let's do that. Trees, garden decor, must be that one. Stained glass, yes, the stained glass is your greenhouse pieces. You do get your effect on aberration no matter what you use, but she's got hers with those, so we're just going to do regular. If I have enough supplies. Alright, so walls. Let's do ...40. Don't know how many I need. Ceilings. Probably about 15. Need 2 doors. And always take extra in case you break them. Smoke roofs, always. I don't like to do square boxes. I like to do something a little different. Another 15. And if you're doing slopes, you gotta have your left and your right. We only have one crafting queue left, so let's do. 6 of those. Let's see if we can go pick us out a spot. Alright, foundations are mostly done. That's enough to get us started for the moment. Yeah, we're just gonna go toward a water source. Let me take something that will also protect me. Hello, creatures. And my daughter has went to breathing again. There's my ravager. Now let's see if we can get it out of this pack. Apparently not. So, let's do it this way. Sometimes, okay, well, let's see if it'll work itself out of the hole. And it will not. She hit J and had everyone follow her, and now everything is all nice and excuse me, locked up tight. All right, now that we got him out, I'll actually go back inside real quick, gather some more parts. And that's my torch I built, burning fungal wood. Burns a purple. It's included in my stacker mod, Chief Stack Large. There's the angler gel, even has the blob still on it. That one over there is spark powder. And that one way down there that's more yellow is thatch. Let's see what we have ready. Almost everything. We're also going to make a couple of items. It's going to make life so much easier. Alright, so we got our lefts. Let's get our rights. Alright. Now, we do also have egg and poop collector, which makes life so much easier. And half the time I don't know where to find all this stuff, so give me just a moment. Let's go to structures. I think something is miscellaneous. Yes, thatch and fertilizer silo. Crystal, electronics, metal ingots. Let's do about four of those. Now we need the egg and poop collector, so I think some of this is not in farming. Oh, the electrical. Yeah. There we go. We want the collector, we just need one. Maybe I had the other one a second ago. We want the large compost bin that's actually part of there. The Jones collector. And charcoal fiber thatch wood. timber, thatch, and you can use fungal wood for any wood source. Just need... Yeah, let's just do one of those. It's just a greenhouse. Alright, silos to hold the fertilizer that actually auto-feeds your crop plots. Collector to collect surrounding dinos' poop. Alright, where was I? Oh, and a generator source. So let's put all this back. Not that. Let's get us a generator. Ooh, we don't have much gas left. Always gonna mess something up. So let's go get us a spot. Let me do one thing. Until the compost bins get some fertilizer in them to start the process. Crop plots. Kind of another one. Ah, where's the crystals? I find it best to put a greenhouse near water sources. Easier to irrigate than to set up. Water tanks. to collect it only when it rains, which I'm not going to collect on Aberration. So over there, she's got her greenhouse. So since I know there's always dinos in this area, so the egg collector can collect them. Well, we can just put it on that island up there. Somebody has a box over there. So we're just going to put here, it's just going to be a temporary one. I changed my mind. Going back over there. There's no dinos to collect poop. Experimental dropped meshes I have in my stacker mod. If it drops fungal wood and or regular wood, I had to differentiate. Find it easier putting everything in my quick bar. Now as the ground slopes up, you want to be high enough to put all your foundations down. So if you were to drop it here, as you can see, it drops lower. Thanks, Rabby. You might run out of room, but if you stack them a little closer up here, you'll have a little bit more room to put more foundations. But they'll snap further down than they will go up. They don't like going up. Let's get one more row. That's a little too low for it, apparently. guess this one's gonna be longer. No, I've got crop plots. And might not need the stairs. Let's put them in anyway. There. That'll work. The vanilla greenhouse pieces leave a slight gap on Castle Keeps. Well, use vanilla structures if that's going to be a problem for you. I'm just going to go ahead and put all the greenhouse parts here. Oh, it looks like they might be fixed. We'll put two doors. Just because. Now there's no round pieces, but I have an idea or two with that. Lay it out however you want to. Remember, chief style of building, no squares. Now, just before we put the last bit in, let's put down a couple of intersections. Now just try to pick lines. Since we have some room. Tell you what, we will wait to see if these taps actually will service all of them, and I'll show you what I mean by that in a little bit. Got them in there. Oops. Keep forgetting. out there? I'm not sure that's going to pick up yet. No, it won't. So... do an incline. Okay. That looks close enough. Notice these can slide, so when you're on the ends, I did it a second ago, and they're overlapped right there, it'll hang out over the edge, so just look a little to the left, and it looks bad up there, but it cleans up that edge a little more. Pull the first one? Apparently not. Alright, that's clean enough. That's the basics, the greenhouse building. Now, just to show you how it works, let's go get some crop pots. Let's check, see if they have fixed the... No, I still think I see a gap. There you go. Yeah, there's still a gap between the little greenhouse pieces with castle keeps. But a dino or a player trying to get into that little gap, good luck. So this is what it looks like, aerial view. It's not too bad, it's not square, it's square-ish. But not totally. Feel free to experiment with building. Alright, crop pots. I forgot to make. And we need to plant something. will also be a tutorial on how to get the plant Z seeds. Which is one of these. It's like species X on the island. But also gives you these fruits here. Right here. Oh, that's got to be in the quick bar. We call these flashbangs. You throw them, and everything gets stunned in the area, including you. I can't tell where I'm going. Who's got seeds? Probably Stego. Or even the Parasitium. Alright. Not enough seeds, actually. Where is Stego? There he is. Oh, nothing. Come on. citronelle, fruit, lemongrass, and we'll do some narco berries. We can have us a farm. Dropped stone. Before we go in, let's show you how to get a plant Z seed. See these little plants here? You walk up to them, they will open. Leaves will fall down. Unfortunately, this is going to be pretty boring. If you wait for approximately a minute or two, it'll spit out a steam for you. But you have to stay near it. Earthquakes. Now, when you see that long vine sticking out, what we'll call a tongue, and retract, it's getting ready to spit the seed out. There's the seed. Now this is a seed, not a fruit. Okay, so up here we're going to have our collectors and our generator. Now the generator just needs to be close to the pig and poop collector items. Generator. The reason why I like my generator is because you can pick it up. Here and in here, I already got one. In here, you need to put thatch it will do its for you. Now, I need some silos. They are stacked. They're kind of small, so that makes me convenient. I also need to be powered, but again, they're still powered wirelessly. Now these then take the fertilizer from the compost bin and stores it. It also enables sending fertilizer to crops. Automatically. I wish they would work on that door sound. These are probably enabled by default. The range on these is pretty reasonable. So in here, it will get the surrounding area. Probably sends it this far, maybe, to the crop plots, maybe further. I don't know the exact range, but it is a pretty good range. Hello, Jacob. Now, for my stacker mod, I have adjusted the collecting of the crop plots where it goes beyond the 300 for berries and 150 for veggies. So you do not need a lot. I'm only going to be making a lot here for narcoberries. Now, the first thing you want to check when you put them down is we do have a greenhouse effect, even though this is aberration and you're inside a world. The developers were nice to give you the greenhouse effect. And the blue section there, it is irrigated. So this tap reaches a distance around the tap. You don't have to put the tap directly in the crop plot. Just needs to be nearby and you will get water. Now we'll feed the crop plots manually first. Because we'll need to put thatch in that compost bin anyway. That'll be enough for the narco berries for now, because these will collect up to 10,000 berries. And I only have 6 seeds anyway, and I don't want 7 crop plots. So let's do this side with narco berries. How much have I got? Oh, I could probably fill it up. All right. some reason, sometimes it doesn't actually grow the crop for me until I wait for a second, so I usually wait to back out of the crop plot. That one actually grew instantly, because I like to pull away and see the actually hatched, or hatched, actually sprouted. That's funny, I know. Seed's still there, I wait till it disappears, and then more fertilizer, and then you got your little seedling. Now, alright, that'll take care of narkleberries. If you wait long enough, they produce a pretty good bit. Now over here, I'm only going to produce one. These will collect up to 10,000 on the vegetables. All right, that's rocket. Long grass. Save a root. Potatoes. Lemons or oranges, whatever citrusy you like, might even be grapefruit. Who knows? And carrots, and these are much needed for sweet veggie cakes. Come on, team. We have those all planted, they've sprouted. Oh, that was weird. Disappeared and came back. Now, since we only had one, just to plant it. Seed. And load it up with fertilizer. And there you go. Now it will start producing fruit that you will find in the crop plot, not the plant. The plant has no options, I think. If it does, it's just players or damage. Players or dinos. There's your basic garden. Feel free to put crop pots wherever you want. Am I forgetting? you so close. Whoops. I need my pick. Where's my other pick? Whoops. Alright, now for that you just need trees. This is not the most efficient way to get thatch, but it is the best so far. I think the Therini or the Megatherium gathers it better, but those animals aren't available here on Aberration. So unfortunately, the pick or Dicrus, Anki, Stego, Perseutin, those kind of things. Maybe even the Diplo. Whoops. Don't touch that mushroom right there in the middle. My pick is just touching the top of it now. The cone-shaped one. That will hallucinate you. Just because I'm an experimental person. Uh-oh. Now I'm hallucinating and fixing to get... And I cannot walk straight. I have to force it straight. So the last final touch to keep your greenhouse self-sustaining. It's loading the compost bin with that, and it needs quite a bit. But now that you've got the thatch and the poop, it will start generating its own fertilizer shortly. And it, yes, gathers all poop. Whether it uses it or not, I don't know. But as you can see, we've already just sitting here, not even near a base. Actually, it is near a base, but put it where you've got wild animals, and you will have poop like nobody's business. And already collected 2 dodo eggs. But you can then take all those back to your base. So for today's video, please like and subscribe. If you got any more tutorials you want, feel free to, why I came out of cave you, I have no idea. Feel free to ask in the comments below. And we will see you next time. Guys, just as a side note, we just built this. What this greenhouse is missing? Some torches. Some light. Anyway, we just built that greenhouse. This one over here. area built. As you can see, this is the stained glass greenhouse. It also has the greenhouse effect. If I'm not mistaken, I think its parts actually sit onto... Oh, she's using vanilla woodland foundations. Never mind. But anyway, this is the first greenhouse we had. We have all that other stuff here in a little tight spot. Thank you, Sir Bud. Sir Budley. Anyway, this is how we ran that. Similar idea. I always have two inputs that way. If one gets broke by dinos or players, you got a backup. And sometimes you can even come down through the foundations to come out, but I just come straight out. And these are Castle Keep's stained glass. And that's this greenhouse. It's square-ish, but it has not a box roof, so it passes the Chief's building criteria. Not that I implement that on anybody else, it's just me. Anyway, that was just a hey, different ways to build greenhouses. And we'll see you later.